गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माई क्लास. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ मोमेंट्स एंटाइटल्ड एज द लॉस्ट चाइल्ड, रिटन बाय मुल्क राज आनंद, एंड वी विल ऑल्सो लर्न फ्यूचर कॉन्टिन्यूस टेंस. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज क्लास. सो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सप्लीमेंट्री रीडर इन इंग्लिश मोमेंट्स. इट्स फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज The Lost Child, authored by Mulk Raj Anand. This is the story of a small boy who was going to a fair with his parents. There he was very curious to purchase everything that he saw on his way, but his parents did not allow him to buy any of them. Later on, a stranger offered him everything that he wanted earlier, but he refused to take anything of them. So let's read. Why did he do so? Let's read and discover. I have prepared its paraphrasing for you all. Paraphrasing means I have simplified the actual language that is given in the book in simple language. So let's start. Recently I told you that the little boy who is the protagonist in the story, protagonist means main character, he was going to a fair with his parents. So it was the festival of spring, and this line I have quoted from the chapter. From the wintry shades of narrow lanes and alleys emerged a gaily clad humanity. It was the festival of spring. Children, do you know when does spring season begin? Spring begins at the ending of winter season. So what is the meaning of these lines which I have quoted as it is from the chapter? From the wintry shades of narrow lanes and alleys emerged a gaily clad humanity. Wintry shades means before spring, winter was going on, so people must be remaining indoors. But now, as spring season began, spring is the season in which flowers bloom and the plants and trees started bearing new leaves and buds. So from the wintry shades of narrow lanes, now as the spring season started, the fair was being organized and the people came out of wintry shades. Maybe they people were remaining indoors during the winter season because of extremely cold and narrow lanes. They were coming out of narrow streets and alleys. Alleys also narrow passages or streets. Emerged means came out. Gaily clad humanity. Gaily means very bright, and clad means dressed. Humanity here means people, human beings. That means the people who came out of their houses in the pleasant spring season, because they were going to the fair, they were wearing very bright dresses. Hope you have understood the meaning of this line. Emerged means came out, gaily means very brightly, clad means dressed. So let's proceed. A little boy was going to the fair with his parents. This I have recently told you. He was brimming over with life and laughter. Brimming over means he was full of. He was full of life and laughter. That means he was very cheerful. He was extremely happy. He was joyous. It's so obvious for children. They become very happy when they go to any fair or any fete or any such kind of enjoyable organization. Brimming means overflowing. Now, next point. He lagged behind, fascinated by the toys in the shops. So his parents called him, "Come child, come." He lagged behind. He lagged behind means he remained backwards. Rather, his parents moved forward. Why did he lag behind? Because he was attracted by the toys in the shops. So his parents called him, "Come child, come." Next point, he obeyed his parents, but his eyes still lingered on the toys. Although he obeyed his parents, he started moving forward, he started going to his parents, he joined them. But
where was his vision? Where were his eyes still? Still her eyes were there on the toys. Lingered means stayed back. He requested his parents to buy him a particular toy. He just started pleading or requesting his parents to buy him a particular toy. Next point, his father looked at him red-eyed. What is the meaning of this phrase red-eyed? That means his father, being an angry man, being a stern person, looked at him angrily. Being red-eyed means to be extremely angry in his familiar tyrant's way. Familiar means that was very common to him, that was a very common attribute of his personality. That means anger. I am talking about anger and tyrant's way. He was behaving like a cruel ruler and it was his common attribute. His mother drew his attention in front of him. So children, usually it happens with children that if their father treats them so angrily, so their mother saves them from the anger of their father. In order to divert the attention of the child, his mother drew his attention by saying, "Child, just see what is there in front of you." It was a mustard field. So the mother of the child was drawing his attention towards a beautiful mustard field before him. Again, I have quoted this line from the text. Like melting gold as it swept across miles and miles of even land. Now children, in this line a figure of speech has been used, that is simile. What is simile? In simile, two objects are compared using the words as or like. So we can see those beautiful yellow flowers, yellow mustard flowers, have been compared to melted gold. As melted gold sweeps across an area, in the same manner the beautiful yellow flowers of mustard field, they had covered the field across miles and miles of land. Next point. Some dragon flies were flying there noisily and intervening the flight of a black bee or butterfly. They were there to suck nectar from the flowers. So I told you that some dragon flies were flying there. What are dragon flies? As I have drawn in the picture, dragon flies are long and thin insects with bright, gaudy, purple colored wings. So they were flying there noisily. Noisily means creating noise, and intervening. Intervening means interrupting. What they were interrupting? They were interrupting the flight of a black bee or butterfly. So I have drawn butterflies and black bee also here for you. Butterfly and black bee, they were trying to get to some flowers in order to suck its nectar. So their flight was being intervened by these dragonflies, because those dragonflies were bigger and more powerful than those black bee and butterfly. Next point, he joined his parents for a while, but again stopped, attracted by many little insects and worms which were teeming out of their hiding places. Once for a while he joined his parents, but again now his attention was attracted by small insects which were coming out. Teeming out means coming out in groups, coming out in swarms. Swarm is a collective noun for insects. As you can see, I have drawn these insects. So these small insects were coming out of their hiding places because it was pleasant sunny weather. Next point, again he was called by his parents from a grove. As he went there, he started collecting raining petals, then dropped the petals, getting attracted by doves. Now his parents called him from a grove. What is grove? Grove means a group of trees. As he went there, they people stood there in order to to take rest in shade because it was extremely sunny now. As he went there, he started collecting raining petals. So as we have read in this line that very beautiful, very pleasant atmosphere was there. The beautiful petals of those beautiful flowers were raining over there, were falling down over there. What are petals? Petals, flat and fragrant part of the flowers. So the boy started collecting those petals, then dropped the petals, getting attracted by doves. Now his attention went towards doves. What are doves? Doves are birds of pigeon family. They are either light grayish color or white color, and you must be knowing that white doves are considered to be a symbol of peace and purity.